Greetings. Let's look at Surah 355. Mushin Khan. And when Allah said, O Jesus, I will take you and raise you to myself and clear you of those who disbelieve, and I will make those who follow you superior to those who disbelieve until the day of resurrection. Then you will return to me, and I will judge between you in the matters in which you used to dispute. Yusuf Ali, translation. Behold, Allah said, O Jesus, I will take thee and raise thee to myself and clear thee of those who blaspheme. I will make those who follow thee superior to those who reject faith, to the day of resurrection. Then shall ye all return unto me, and I will judge between you of the matters wherein you dispute. The Pickthall translation reads, When Allah said, O Jesus, lo, I am gathering thee and causing thee to ascend unto me, and am cleansing thee of those who disbelieve, and am setting those who follow thee above those who disbelieve until the day of resurrection. Then unto me you will return, and I shall judge between you as to that wherein you used to differ. The Sahih International Translation. When Allah said, O Jesus, indeed I will take you and raise you to myself and purify you from those who disbelieve, and make those who follow you superior to those who disbelieve until the day of resurrection. Then to me is your return, and I will judge between you concerning that in which you used to differ. That is four translations. I'm being as honest and objective as I can. Let's look phrase by phrase. Mushin Khan. And when Allah said, O Jesus. Ali. Behold, Allah said, O Jesus. When Allah said, O Jesus. And Sahih. When Allah said, O Jesus. Let's all agree this claims to be Allah speaking to Jesus. Okay? I will take you and raise you to myself. I will take thee and raise thee to myself. I am gathering thee and causing thee to ascend unto me. Indeed, I will take you and raise you to myself. This phrase claims Allah will raise Jesus to himself. Anyone disagree? And clear you of those who disbelieve. And clear you of those who blaspheme, and am cleansing thee of those who disbelieve, and purify you from those who disbelieve. Allah is going to cleanse or clear or purify Jesus from disbelievers and blasphemers. He's going to separate them from Jesus. Can you still see it? Still in agreement? Now here is where it begins to get interesting, because Allah is going to make a promise. And I will make those who follow you, I will make those who follow thee, and am setting those who follow thee, and make those who follow you. Okay, so Allah is going to make all who follow Jesus something superior to those who disbelieve, superior to those who reject faith, above those who disbelieve, superior to those who disbelieve, superior over above those who disbelieve or reject faith. And the next phrase says when and how long this promise is going to last. Till the day of resurrection. To the day of resurrection. Until the day of resurrection. And until the day of resurrection. Until the day of resurrection, or the last day, or judgment day, call it what you will. Can we all agree that the day of resurrection has not yet happened? Therefore, this promise is still in effect. We are left with three possibilities. 1. Allah did not make this promise to begin with. 2. Allah promised but did not fulfill His promise. 3. Allah promised and fulfilled, and the world reflects the promise as it is, because the day of resurrection has not happened yet, and this promise was until the day of resurrection. Those who call themselves Muslim must reject 1, because if the Quran said it, then it is the word of Allah. Allah made this promise. Those who call themselves Muslim must reject 2. If Allah promised it, it must have been fulfilled just as He said. Those who call themselves Muslims must therefore claim 3. Allah promised it, it was fulfilled, and the world reflects this promise. But if this is true, those who are superior in the earth are the true believers that Allah has made superior, and the inferior are the disbelievers who reject true faith in Jesus Christ. Remember, Allah made the true believers in Jesus superior. Remember, the true believers follow the true belief about Jesus, because Allah separated Jesus from the disbelievers. So what is the superior belief in the world today? The dominant belief in the world today and the last 1,000 years has been that Jesus is the Son of God. So either Allah has made the worship of the Son of God the superior belief, or Surah 355 is not true and Allah has not kept His promise. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.